Good evening. We are here in a Tanwir farm here in Nablus, Palestine. This center for culture, for political issues in Palestine, to talk about what happened in Palestine. Today we are talking with our uncle Abu Ahmad Yazouri. He is from our area, 1948. I will introduce myself, Miasser Atiani, active in a prisoner's issue, member of the Tanwir Center here in Nablus, working with a team here in Tanwir to do something good for our Palestinian issue, to let all the world see what happened here in Palestine. Graduated from Najah University, working with Women Union. And today we are talking about what happened in 1948, about the catastrophe from the Zionists when they control our land, take off our land in 1948. And to talk about this, not me, because I wasn't born that time. So Abu Ahmad Yazouri, we will introduce him to talk about what happened in 1948. مساء الخير أبو أحمد.
مساء النور.
أهلا وسهلا فيك.
إياك يا الله.
نعرف من أي بلد أنت ومن أي قرية من أي مدينة بأرض عام 48.
أنا من قرية اسمها يازور قرب يافا، تبعد 2 كيلو عن مدينة يافا، تحدها من الشمال يافا والبحر، ومن الجنوب سلمة والخيرية، ومن الغرب اللد والرملة. من الجنوب اللد والرملة، من الجنوب
الجنوب اللد والرملة، ومن الغرب البحر.
عدد سكانها
من الشمال ايش؟
من الشمال يافا، من الغرب يافا والبحر.
يافا والبحر من الغرب. والشمال؟
الشمال سلمة والخيرية.
سلمة والخيرية قرى.
نعم.
والجنوب؟
الجنوب اللد والرملة.
الجنوب اللد والرملة. الشرق؟
الشرق برضو سلمة برضو.
سلمة. He is from Yazouf village. Yazouf village destroyed by the Zionists in 1948 when they occupied our land. Yazouf is a village near Yafa city. It's surrounded by from south the Ramle city, from west Yafa and the sea, from north the villages of Salama and Al-Khiriyya. From north Salama and when did you come from?
No, I'm in 48.
من كيف؟
قديش كان عمرك؟ أقول لك قديش عدد سكان البلد أول
شيء. قديش كان عمرك أول شيء؟
عمري كان 8 سنوات.
8 سنين، أنت وأهلك؟
نعم.
كلياتكم، قديش أفراد الأسرة؟
حالياً ولا زمان؟
لا، يوم ما تهجرتوا.
يوم ما تهجرنا بقينا أكثر من 60.
60. وأنت وأبوك وأمك وأم العيلة بس؟
العيلة بقينا 6. العيلة، أما الفاميلي أكثر من 60.
لا، عليك كل 60. طيب شو صار معكم؟
احنا اول شيء صحابين ارض وصحابين حق. نحن من جذور هذا البلد هي فلسطين. نحن من الراسخين في هذه البلد، وبنثبت في هذا الحكي انه نحن موجودين قبل الانتداب البريطاني وقبل اليهود، وهذا نحن ملاكين ارض من ايام تركيا. لما كان احنا كنا في فلسطين لا كان الانتداب البريطاني ولا كان الاسرائيليين ولا كان اليهود.
I asked him to talk about himself and about his family. What happened in that time in 1948 when the Zionists occupied our area? But he prefers to talk about what happened in general. That he says that Palestine is our land. It is our right to defend Palestine, and we are the people whom have the rights of the land. Look, he shows us this paper. This paper for the time of the Turkish occupied here in Palestine. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم دولة علي العثمانية هاي بيزور 1315 1316 1315 and this paper a document for a land in Yazoo. And this في التسجيل اللي بتلطع ديك.
هاي تريد
تلاب دول. And this is as I told you be in Turkish occupied. This is when Britain occupied Palestine. There had been Palestine government, but under the British occupied. This is certificate of registration, land registry office of Palestine government. This document, look, this is certificate, Yafa, Yazur. The suit is area near Yazur, and the kind of land, decision of the land, it is for planting, how many meters, the name of the owner of the owner Aisha, Aisha Musammam Bani Ibrahim Bani Ahmad. And here from Abdul Jabbar Ibrahim Ahmad. This papers belongs to people. This papers belong to people whom they until now. Look, this is the size of the area. 11 dunam, 188 meters. And everything is right here in this certificate. Certificate of Registration. A lot of papers here from the past, from while the Turkish occupation, the date 1280, and the owners. This is, look, if you can't write at that time, you can put your stamp like this. Like this. To put your signature by your finger. And this is legal at that time to put it. And those papers, not for عقد زواج. This is a deal to sell a land from Abdul Aziz to Hassan. It is legal. And the coin, Palestinian, Jinin, Palestini. The coin was Palestinian. 81 Palestinian coins here. And look the date, 1931, August 14, 1931. And this is the signature of the office that it is legal. And this is those. This is that if Abu Ahmad want to sell his land to another Palestinian, look, the Zionists said that they sold, the Palestinians sold their lands to the Israeli with two quotation, never. This is from Abdul Jabir Ibrahim Sheikh Saleh to Mahmoud Ibrahim Hamad Sheikh Saleh. So from Palestinian to another Palestinian, just. And what they said, it is not good. This is in English and in Arabic. Because that time, British were there.
Hold it?
Yeah. land registry office of the same in Arabic and in English. And some papers, a certificate when a child born like this.
Does it show the place of birth?
Yeah, the place of birth. Yeah. And this is the taxes that the Palestinian had been paid for the British occupation. Here, a paper, taxes, this is the number of taxes, and this is the number of 740 fair Guinea Palestinian from, it was paid from Mahmoud Hassan Bassiouni to the British government at that time. The people, the Palestinian, had been paid taxes for them, like this. And this is application form for loan for Cretas cultivation. This is نموذج طلب قرض لمزروعات الأثمار الحمضية. As you had known that our area, Yazur, Haifa, Yafa, full of lemons. And this is application to take a loan for your land if you want to continue or to grow more and more. The date here, 1940, 1941.
Let me see that.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, I have it.
The farmers at that time write this application because they want to continue their life and to plant more and more lemons in their lands. كنتوا تاخذوا هاي القروض عشان تشتروا الاراضي. I asked him why they take this loan.
كل هاي ضرائب كنا ندفع كمان ضرائب.
All of these papers taxes.
كل هاي ضرائب.
Taxes. For the British, كل البريطانيين.
كل سنة كنا ندفع ضرائب.
Revenue tax receipt. عيد
كم واحد وكم سنة.
Revenue tax receipt. This is taxes. هاي جنين. إيش هاي؟ البنك العثماني. This is for the British bank.
أيام تركيا.
As أبو أحمد said, عن إيش هاي الورقة؟ طب هاي هي أنا عارفة هياتها. هاي استحقاق. Look, when they took the loan here for their plants, they have to sign this to the bank. So this paper from the bank that the farmer paid the money instead of the money he had taken from the British occupied or government at that time. Yeah. 24 August 1948. Ayata Othman, Othman Bank. C 1942-1948.
What are the stamps there?
The stamp here?
No, the colored stamps.
The colors. Palestine, 20 mil. This is what the Palestinian pay for the paper. But the coin, as I told you before, Palestinian at the Turkish occupation.
Let me go in closer to that. Yes, Palestine.
Yeah. Palestine, yeah. الطابع هذا ستامب. Look, government of Palestine. Government of Palestine in English, حكومة فلسطين in Arabic and the wells in Hebron. This is at the period of the British occupation.
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. This is another paper that Mr. Muhammad Ibrahim Sheikh Saleh Yazur had to buy 9 Palestinian Geneva Kumbiala. It is for rent something, and this is Palestinian stamps. This is George Street in Jaffa. George Street in Jaffa, Palestine. كيف قدرت تجمع كل هاي الأوراق وتطلعهم معك؟ I ask him when he had gone from our land, Liazur, how he collect all the papers and get it with him. كيف بدك تجمع هذا؟
أول إشي هدول مش كلهم اللي إنا. في كمان قدهم في الأردن. نحن أول إشي ملاكين في فلسطين وصحابين أرض وصحابين أملاك. وإحنا حافظنا على الأرض ما خرجنا بأول يوم ولا بتاني يوم ولا بأول مرة. وسيدي استشهد في يافا، قتل في 36، وهاجمونا عدة مرات على يزور، يهاجمونا ونردهم.
يعني أول ما دخلوا ضليتوا في البلد؟
نعم، ما خرجنا ولا من أول مرة ولا من ثاني مرة ولا من 10 مرة ولا من 20 مرة.
لحظة أحمد، he says that those papers is not all the papers that they can they could take from Yazur with them. He and his Abu Talamak, and he and his father and the family. It is a very small papers, and a lot of our papers with the, in Jordan now with the government of Jordan, because West Bank was the, under control with the Jordanian government. But he says that when the Zionists began their war inside our area in 1948, they didn't go away or withdraw immediately. قديش قعدتوا؟ How many قديش قعدتوا في البلد قبل ما طلعتوا؟
احنا قعدنا كثير، طلعنا وردينا رجعنا، وقعدنا يقاوم كل اهل البلد يعني. ما خرجوا بالسلام عليكم الا ما عندما ما بلشوا يقتلوا بالنساء، والدعايات اللي كانوا يعملوها برا انه ذبحوا الشيوخ وذبحوا النساء وذبحوا الاطفال وذبحوا الردع وخدعوا. نعم، هاجرنا على الليل.
At the beginning they stayed in Yazur. They didn't afraid. They continue some of the young in their village had weapons and continue to fight against the Zionists. But not enough. They had gone outside the village and returned back twice or three times. Then what happened, as Abu Ahmed says, because of the media, they heard that the Zionists were killing the women, killing the children. The radios, the Arab radios, asked all of them to go outside. Because they were want to save their lives by the media, so they had gone with all their families. 60 كان من حمولتكم كلياتها.
No.
All the families from Yazur, 60 families from Yazur, they had gone from Yazur. His family 6. أبوك.
أبوي وأمي وستي وعمي 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 وعمي
all of his uncles, his grandmother, his grandfather, his father, his mother, all of them, they had gone. Six of his family were, his father took a decision to go out of Yazoo. He was 6 years. 6 years كان عمره.
8 سنين أو سبعة.
سبعة. 7 years. تتذكر إيش هذيك الفترة؟
طبعاً ولا.
إيش تتذكر؟
كل إشي بتذكر.
أحكي لي.
إلا
I ask him if he remembers anything because he was still young, 7 years. Maybe something in the mind, in the memory, maybe.
يزور طوقة 2 كيلو عن يافا يمر منها شارع من يافا إلى القدس إلى غزة يزور يعني من أكبر المدن التي كانت بهذيك فذاك الزمان يزور كان يوجد فيها 120 أو أكثر من 120 مطار ري عدد سكان فيها 11 مصنع
11
مصنع عدد سكانها 4950 4950 عدد سكان
هذيك الفترة فترة الاحتلال
نعم بال 46 كان هذا العدد كان فيها أكثر من 10 مصانع، أكثر من 120 مطار ري.
إيش هاي المصانع؟
مصانع النسيج، مصانع التنك، مصانع العظم، مصانع الثلج، بابير الطحين، مصنع القزاز.
كله بيزور؟
نعم.
He remembers something very important that in 1964 the population in Yazoo A number, he gave us a number, 4,950 persons in Yazoo in 1964. And all of them forced to leave Yazoo because of the Zionists. And they left Yazoo. He said that Yazoo far away just 2 kilometers from Haifa.
Yeah.
And Yaffa, sorry, from Yaffa. And there was a road, train, القطار.
No, sir.
There was a
road. في قطار كمان.
There was a. أنا بتذكر
في قطار. في قطار.
There was a road, two roads, one by train, another long road between Yaffa inside Yazoo to Jerusalem. And all of the people in Yazoo were working in their plants and the lemons. And in Yazoo there were 10 factories for glass, yufarts, sweeped, a lot of things. كل كان أهل يازور يشتغلوا غاد ولا المحيط
لا يازور كان في كمان يجي من المحيط يشتغل
مصانع صغيرة يعني
لا هاي لا يازور كانت النسيج والتنك وال والثلج والطحين والهسرة ومعمل قزاز وعدة مصانع يعني.
Workshops inside Yazoo for the people themselves. They worked inside Yazoo to earn money beside their working in fields of lemons. بس كان مصدرهم الأساسي الليمون.
الليمون والبرتقال. No.
Orange and lemon, their main earn for money in Yazoo.
Is this the original key to his home? This key?
I want to ask him what this key mean to him. شو يعني لك هذا المفتاح؟
هذا المفتاح. هذا مفتاح لن أنسى مدى حياتي.
I will not forget this key all my life.
هذا مفتاح بلدي وبيتي وبيت أجدادي.
جبته معه.
نعم، أبوي جابه معه.
This key is for their house in Yazoo. His father brought it with them. And for Abu Ahmad, he will continue his father's promise that he will not forget this key and his house in Yazoo. تعتقد راح ترجع Yazoo يعني راح تفتح؟
نعم سأحكي لك قصيدة لن أنساها مدى حياتي.
I ask him, you believe that you will return back to Yazoo and you will open your house, بيتك لسه موجود؟
نعم موجود، أنا رحت عليه عدة مرات موجود.
Before his answer, I asked him if his house is still to put the key inside the door and open it. He said that his house is still until
أكثر
now.
أكثر من 200 مرة. أكثر من 200 مرة.
بتروح بتشوف بيتك؟
نعم أكثر من 200.
كيف بيكون شكلك ووضعك؟
بالنسبة لي أبوي اللي بيتأثر أكثر مني.
أبوك في الصعية؟
أبوي لا اتوفى من البيت. وقف أبوي من البيت. ورحت أنا وأبوي على يادور. رحت أنا وأبوي بجوز أكثر من 300 مرة على يادور.
Me, he and his father return back to Yazur to see Yazur and their house more than 300 times.
أكثر من كمان.
كيف كنت تشوف تفوتوا عادي
أول مرة.
I ask him about the first time.
لما وصلنا يافا بدأ يبكي.
The first time when we returned, me, he and his father.
قلنا له
when he reached Yafa, his father began to cry.
قلنا له بدنا نروح على يزور. صار يبكي.
He told his father that they will go to Yazur, but his father began to shout while he was crying.
وإحنا ماشيين ورايحين على يزور.
While they were walking to go to Yazur,
يصرخ بأعلى صوته.
He was crying in a loud voice.
لما وصلنا باب يزور راح يغمى عليه.
When they entered the beginning of Yazur, his father began to not to see anything, something like this happened to him.
أو يفقد الوعي.
He began to be ill, something like this.
في هاي الحالة دورنا ورجعنا ما دخلناه.
They didn't enter Yazur because his father began to be ill and they return back. أي سنة هاد؟
'67-'68.
بعد احتلال الدخل.
بعد الاحتلال.
This first time was in 1968 after the Zionist occupied the West Bank.
بعد أكثر من شهر ومريض.
When they return back, his father for a month was in bed with illness.
أنا كان إلي عمل في تل أبيب يعني أشتري للمحل تبع البضاعة. كنت دائما أخذه معي مرة على مرة على مرة على مرة لما رضي يستوعب إنه يروح على يزور.
Because his father believe of his land and his house. أبو أحمد had something to work in Tel Rabia with two quotation Tel Aviv now. And he took his father with him time by time to let him deal that he can enter Yazur and see Yazur. وتعود؟
نعم بعد أكثر من سنة.
After 1 year his father agreed to go to Yazur. وافق على يزور؟
بعد أكثر من سنة وعدة محاولات.
After a lot of times his father agreed to go to Yazur. رحت زرت يزور؟
زرنا يزور أكثر من 300 مرة.
فت داركا؟
فتنا شربونا مي يا يوم.
كيف وضعك كان؟
طبعا يكون وضعه يعني هو بقول لك أنا يا عمي أنا الثاني أنا مش من هون جابوني ضحكوا علي جابوني من برا وعلوني هون.
I asked him if they enter their house when they return back the first time. Abu Ahmed said that the first time they entered he and his father entered Yazur and they were at the gate of their house. His father hesitated to go inside the house. But Abu Ahmed encouraged his father to enter the house. They knocked the door of their house and a foreigner were in their house. A Jewish, they opened the door and Abu Ahmed and his father asked them to let them to see the house. But what had happened that the Jewish told them that it is not their fault. They came from outside and Zionists gave them this house. Abu Ahmed told them, but it is my house. They said it is our house, not yours.
What were their names?
تتذكر اسمهم اليهود اللي فتوا عليهم في داركم؟
لا بس احنا اولا بال 46 وقبل 46 بالاربعينات كان عندنا يهود عايشين في فلسطين نسبتهم من 5 إلى 6%. وكنا احنا واليهود اللي ساكنين بفلسطين بهذاك الزمان زينا زي الاهل، العزا واحد والاكل واحد والشرب واحد والفرح واحد.
لما دخلتوا الدار شو كان شعورك بهذا الشعور اللي كنت فيه ايامها؟
ولا طبعا تاثر كثير ابوي، تاثرنا زياده عن اللزوم بهذا الحكي. وبقول لك ابوي راح ليغمى عليه عده مرات يعني في دور.
بس شعرت انهم هم نفس اليهود اللي كنتوا بتتعاملوا معهم.
في يوم من الايام عملوا لقاء مع ابوي، قالوا لهم مستعد امشي حبي من هين لا 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 يزور بس اقعد في حبي.
He said that he didn't remember the names of the Jewish family inside their house. And what happened, his father began to cry, his tears full off his face, and he returned back, he put his back like this on his on the house. Just as he say goodbye my house, because he is old, he can't return back to see this house. But he asked Abu Ahmad to continue visiting Yazur and to go to the house to see it. Maybe one day they will return back to Yazur. This is what his father Abu Ish Abu Isma.
Abu Ali.
Abu Ali, his father Abu Ali told them, and Abu Ahmad says, we will continue what our father asked us. But Abu Ahmad told us something, that before 1964, because I asked him about his feeling when he entered the house and a Jewish family inside their house. What happened? He said it was a lot of sadness for him and his father that that time they were astonished or something broken in their heart that their house now is not their house. There is a Jewish family in their house. He said, but we before 1964 and 1948, there were Jewish in Palestine. We were together, Muslims, Christian, and Jewish. And if a Jewish person died, all of the Yazur men went to say sorry that he was died. If there is a celebration or married, all of them go and to celebrate with them. The same for Jewish, as religious. So they were together, they lived in Palestine, in Yaffa together. They were in Yaffa from 5 to 6% Jewish in Yaffa at that time, and they were neighbors. They eat together, they play together. Even when, while they were youth, they play together. But what happened, it is different when they return back to their house. And a Jewish family from... تعرف من أي بلد اللي كانوا فيها اليهود؟ من أي بلد حكمكم؟
من أمريكا.
The Jewish family were from USA. And they told them, never, it is our house. Return back to West Bank, it is not yours.